running. So we have Maddie Woods talking with us tonight. She is a sophomore from South Bend, Indiana, which is where Notre Dame is from, if you know where that is. So we brought her here, which is awesome. She runs track and cross country, and she is the first woman in her family to go to college. So that's awesome. Thanks. Welcome, Maddie Woods. Today, I would like to share the complete transformation that Jesus has made in my family, relationships, identity, and value. My family has been redeemed by Christ and transformed through God's healing and forgiveness. Jesus has shown me that my identity is in Him and that I have value as a daughter of Christ. My initial exposure to the gospel occurred at a young age. I heard that God sent Jesus to die for the sins of the world, that He rose 3 days later, and that He would someday return. I understood that if I believed in Jesus and repented of my sins, I could be saved. I was also young, about 10, when I accepted Christ and was baptized. However, I did not fully understand the implications of my actions, and my family and I did not live a Christ-centered life. Church happened once a week, and we did nothing to pursue Christ. We lived completely stagnant spiritual lives. I was convinced that my worth came from my academic and athletic accomplishment. Because of the emphasis my sport, distance running, and people around me placed on my weight, I had distorted body image and struggled with an eating disorder. As a result, I was self-absorbed and had developed a true dislike for the sport I once loved. My family was also in a state of disrepair. My parents did not have a godly marriage and were on a path to a failed marriage. I thought they would surely be divorced within the next few years, and I did not believe in marriage for myself. I had a poor relationship with both of my parents. My sister and I saw each other as competitors in pursuit of perfection and approval, therefore damaging our relationship as well. As you can imagine, my sport and family left me feeling less than fulfilled. The second half of my senior year of high school, I was injured with stress fracture after stress fracture. This was undoubtedly related to my eating disorder. By not nourishing my body, I had reduced my bone density to levels that could not handle the stress of running. I was upset that I couldn't train and compete to prove my worth, and I was upset that I had put myself in a position to be injured. These consequences continued throughout my freshman year of college. A few weeks before I left for college, my family had the biggest falling out yet, and I was simply counting down the days until I could make my escape to Ohio State. My failing family supplied plenty of pain, anger, and unforgiveness to contribute to what was one of the most difficult times in my life. While this was a painful time, I'm so thankful for these circumstances. God was setting my family and I up to experience Jesus and be a testimony to the power He has to transform people and heal brokenness. If God had not stepped in, we would have continued on our path of destruction. At the end of my first semester of college, change began to take place. During finals week, my dad was unexpectedly diagnosed with kidney cancer. I was also easily at rock bottom, feeling as worthless as ever with yet another injury. The pure desperation that my family was experiencing reminded us of our imperfection and brokenness, making us extremely responsive to Jesus. It was at this time that Jesus called my father's heart and began a radical change. When I came home for Christmas break, I was shocked at what I found. My father was asking for forgiveness for things I thought he would never apologize for. My parents had become a united front. I was able to have genuine conversation with my sister. Regardless, I still doubted that God could offer the magnitude of mental, physical, and emotional healing that my family and I needed. I was skeptical that anything could permanently repair my parents. I thought they would simply revert to their past behavior over time. However, I was wrong. The conditions of things improved with time. As I continued to observe the healing of my family, my trust in Jesus grew. He was also healing my own heart and mind, supplying me with the power to fight the temptation to deprive my body of nutrition. In April of 2016, I rededicated my life to Jesus. He called me, and there was no doubt in my heart that He is the only answer. This summer, I was baptized with both of my parents and my sister. Since Jesus has become the center of my life and the center of my family, the transformation that has taken place is truly a miracle. My parents' marriage is now Christ-centered, and I have a baby brother that was born in October as living proof. I have a prepared relationship with my parents and sister through Jesus' healing and forgiveness. I know my identity is in Christ and that I have value. I'm now motivated to glorify God in all I do rather than receive earthly accomplishments and affirmation. As a result, I have found joy and gratitude in my sport, and the pressure and perfection of the eating disorder are greatly diminished. As I reflect on the events of the past couple years, I'm reminded of Isaiah 43:19. Behold, I am doing a new thing. Now it springs forth. Do you not perceive it? I will make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. The Lord was using my brokenness to do a new thing, even though I was unable to perceive it. He rescued me from the wilderness by providing a way to Jesus. Jesus deserves all the glory for renewing my family. Things are not in a state of perfection between us, as we are imperfect people, but as we strive to become closer to Jesus, who is perfect, we have to come closer to each other. I'm so thankful that Jesus has redeemed me and my family, and I cannot wait to see how he redeems the rest of our lives.